Hello friends, welcome to my channel T12. Today we are going to discuss about conservation of momentum. Now momentum we have already discussed is represented by the letter p, small p, and is the product of the mass and the velocity, right? The force, in the second law we discussed that force is directly proportional to the rate of the change of momentum. So that was mv minus u divided by p. Remember all these two formula? Now, according to the conservation of momentum, the momentum is conserved after and before the collision. Now, what does this mean? This means that, for example, this is my body with mass ma and initial velocity. Initially, it has a velocity of ua and it's moving in this direction. Similarly, I have another ball which is moving in this direction and has a mass as mb. This is ball a, this is ball b. And initial velocity of ub, it moving in this direction. This is before collision. Now, after some time, these two balls collide. See, like this, they'll move apart. This is before collision. And then after collision, what happens is that this ball, this AB, see, right? So this A, it moves here. And this B, the ball starts here, starts to move here. Now, will the mass change after collision? No. Because it's right, it's mass. There is a collision that is happening. But the final velocity will change. So this will have the final velocity as VA and this will have the final velocity as VB. Now we have all the terms we need. So according to my law of conservation, my initial momentum is equal to my final momentum, right? How do you prove that? You must remember the third law of motion. Now, according to the third law, the force that is applied by A on B is equal and opposite to the force that is applied by B on A. This is a simple thing, right? Now, after you have drawn the diagram, you will say initial mass, mass of ball A, MA, initial velocity of ball A, UA, like that. You will be mentioning everything. Now, since the question says force applied by A on B, so I will take that as mass A mv minus u, mass A, final velocity of A, what is the final velocity of A? It is va, va minus ua divided by t. The time taken is same for both the sides. Similarly, for the other one, I have minus force applied by B is mb, vb minus ub divided by t. Now, since the time taken are same, so I can cancel these two out, right? What I'll get next is MA VA minus UA equals minus MB VB minus UB, right? Now, next what I can do is I can open the brackets. When you open the brackets, you need to multiply this two together and these two together, right? So, I'll get MA VA minus MA UA is equal to minus MB VB minus minus will be plus plus MB UB, right? Now see, these are negative terms. Let's rearrange them. So what I'll do is I'll shift this minus term here and this minus term here. What happens when I do the shifting? So I will have MA VA, this one. This will come here, so it will be plus MB VB is equal to MB UB plus MA UA, right? Like this. Now, from this, have a look. This is my VA VB, so this is my final momentum, since momentum is what? M into V, right? So, this is final momentum and this one has UB and UA, so this is my initial momentum. So, I can say that after collision, my initial momentum and the final momentum are same. So, hence, does this prove the law of conservation of momentum? Can I say that even after the collision, the momentum remains conserved? See, initial equals final. I hope this is clear to you. If you have any issue, please let me know. Next, we will be doing few numericals based on the conservation of momentum. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. If you have any doubt, write a comment section. Bye.